Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. Today in this tutorial, in this back-to-back two or three videos, we are practically going to understand various operations of this union, difference, intersection, and exclusion under various conditions of different elements, whether they are object or they are paths or interacting with object and path of Inkscape tutorial for beginners. So stay tuned. Now in the first case, we will be observing some case study between objects. So what happens when the difference operation is conveyed within two objects? So we can see this is the first one, case one. We'll be practically using two different objects here, the circle and the rectangle. Both of them are objects. So this is the case one when the circle is at the bottom and the rectangle is on top of the circle, and there will be a case two when the reverse thing happens. That means the rectangle is at the bottom and the circle is on top of this rectangle. So we will be observing these cases. Next, we'll be observing the same result and effect of difference operation when the interacting elements are an object and a path. So this case one, when the object or rectangle is at the bottom level and the path is on top of the object, and there goes the case two, when the path is at the lowest level and the object is on top of the path. And something similar should be observed right over here when the difference operation is conveyed between two individual paths. Let's head back to this Inkscape document, and here we will be observing the case one when the circle is at the bottom. There goes the circle, and there will be a rectangle on top of this circle. So we have drawn this circle at the bottom level, and this rectangle is on the top of this bottom level circle. We'll be definitely changing these color properties, all the stroke and fill color. So let's select this rectangle here, and we'll be changing this stroke color to something different here. And there goes this stroke color option here. This is the fill color inside, and this is the stroke color. Now, all we need to do, if we just select this circle, this bottom level circle, and then if we select this rectangle, as we can see here, so both of the objects been selected. And now let's head back to this path. Here comes this difference operation, and we can see that on clicking it, the rectangle is completely disappeared, but the circle remains, and the part of the circle which we are practically crossing over the rectangle, or alternatively we may say that the part of the rectangle which was crossing over the circle, that individual part is being disappeared, and the remaining part of the circle is lying right in front of us. So this is the case when the circle is at the bottom level and the rectangle is on the top level. But what happens when the reverse thing happens? That means we'll be drawing this rectangle first at the bottom level, and then we are about to draw a circle right over here. So now the rectangle is at the bottom and the circle is on the top. So we'll be changing all the stroke and fill color properties here of the circle, of this top level element here. Let's change it to yellow, and let's change the stroke color to something different like this red one. And we can see that part of the circle which is definitely crossing over the rectangle is right over here. Now all we need to do, we need to select both these elements, and if we head back to this path, and next if we click on this difference operation, we can see that definitely the part of the circle which was practically crossing over this rectangle, it is now disappeared. The same part is been cut through the rectangle, through this bottom level element rectangle here, which was lying at the bottom. And we can see on the other hand, it is practically moving as if a single element here. In the prior case, both of them were two distinct elements. These elements were the rectangle and the circle. But right now, both of them are acting as if a single element. Both this rectangle and the part of the circle which was practically crossing over, and the rest part of the circle is disappeared, is gone here. And we can make any changes here. Press this lock icon, and we can see that we can practically make any kind of changes here. We may resize this shape, we may change this dimension, or on the other hand, we may rotate or we may skew, whatever we wish to do. It will be practically imposed on a single element here. So this is the second case. Now, if we head back to the next case, this is the case tool between object and a path. And in the first case, the object rectangle will be at the bottom level and the path will be on top of that individual object. So let's head back to our Inkscape canvas right here. And first of all, let's head back to this file, document properties. And here, all we are going to do, we are going to unselect this show page border option right over here. Now, in the second case, the rectangle will be acting as if a bottom element right over here. So we have drawn a rectangle. Let's keep this stroke and fill color intact as it has been right over here. And in the next case, all we are going to do, we will be drawing an individual path here. So we can see that there goes the path which practically crosses over this individual rectangle at the bottom level. So let's impose some kind of fill color into this path that we have drawn, and let's make it as if this one. Let's change this stroke color into something different, and let's increase this stroke width such that we can see it clearly what is happening. So we can see that in the first case, at the bottom level, there is a rectangle, and on top of it, there is a path that we have drawn. Now all we need to do, we need to select both these elements first, and we'll be heading back to this path, and there goes the difference option. And we can see that the part of the path which was practically crossing over the bottom leveled element rectangle, that part only remains, but the rest part of the path is disappeared, and the similar amount of path which has crossed over into this bottom leveled element rectangle, it practically imposes its shape right over here. So this is the thing happens when the bottom leveled element is an object and the top leveled element is a path. Now let's reverse this case. And in the first case, we will be creating a path here. Let's draw any path. So we have drawn this path right over here, and let's fill some color into it. For say we are filling up this path with this red color, and let's change this stroke color into something different like this yellow one, and let's increase this stroke width right over here. So this is the path, and on top of it, let's create this individual rectangle here, and we will be of course changing this color properties. For say we are making this color right over here, the stroke color, let's keep it something different. So we have placed this object rectangle on top of the path, and now if we select both, and if we head back to path difference, and we can see that the path is now cut and has taken up this individual shape right over here. So this is the thing happens exactly when the bottom leveled element is a path and the top leveled element is an object. Now what happens if we try to interact between two different paths right over here? there goes an example of this operation here between two independent paths, the difference operation between two individual paths. What will be the result? So this is a desired result. So we can see that this individual image, it is practically a resultant of two different independent paths right over here. So let's try to make it up into our Inkscape canvas document. So let's head back to our Inkscape canvas first and let's create a certain path here. So this is the path one. And let's fill color into it. So we have changed both the fill color and the stroke color properties. In the similar manner, we will be creating something different here, like this path here. And here goes the path two. In the similar manner, first of all, let's make it a little bit of smaller and let's put some alternate color into it. Let's change this stroke style and stroke width into something different here. There it goes. And now we are putting it all over the first path that we have created. So we have created here two distinct paths here. The first one is this green colored path and the second one is this blue colored path. Now, if we select both of them, if we head back to path and if we click on this difference operation, we can see that this will be the result practically. We will be having the bottom leveled path into vicinity and the top leveled element is practically disappeared, leaving the traces behind, which practically crossed over the first independent path at the bottom level. So here is the operation between these paths right over here.